breaking news this morning from Washington, D.C. The U.S. Senate has approved its version of the health care reform bill. During an early morning vote, the Senate passed the bill 60-39, straight along party lines. The Democratic-backed plan requires nearly all Americans to buy insurance and forbids companies from denying coverage based on pre-existing conditions. In January, lawmakers will start tough negotiations to ratify this bill with a similar version passed by the House of Representatives back in November. A suicide bomber detonated explosives today in a busy commercial area full of government buildings in Pakistan's northwest city of Peshawar. Authorities say four people were killed and at least 14 others were wounded. The attack was second. It was the second in 3 days in that area and the latest in the wave of violence that has killed more than 500 people in Pakistan since November. Insurgents are suspected of avenging a U.S.-supported Pakistani army offensive against the Taliban in a northwest tribal region along the Afghan border. At least three civilians were killed and dozens of others were wounded in a bomb attack yesterday in Baghdad. Iraqi police say the blast targeted Shiite pilgrims in eastern Baghdad. The explosion took place in Baghdad's Al-Mashtal district and targeted women and children who were gathering to attend a religious ceremony to mark the death of Imam Hussein, the grandson of the Prophet Muhammad. While violence across Iraq is much lower than at the peak of the sectarian killing in 2006 and 2007, Sunni Islamic insurgents continue to target police, soldiers, and civilians. Western China has been hit with a heavy dose of Old Man Winter. Heavy snow hit China's far western Xinjiang region in a storm that began on Tuesday. China State Television reports temperatures in the region have plummeted to 22 degrees below zero. This week's storm is the largest in that region this year. A day-long hostage standoff in rural Virginia is now over. The suspect, Warren Taylor, emerged in his wheelchair late last night after holding three people hostage in a post office for nearly 9 hours. No one was injured, but police had confirmed earlier that shots were fired. Taylor's only demand during the standoff was for pizza, which was delivered in the early evening. He is being questioned, but authorities don't yet know Taylor's motive. The so-called Balloon Boys parents were sentenced yesterday for their roles in a hoax that riveted the world's attention in October. Richard and Mayumi Heaney entered a Colorado courtroom yesterday morning with their lawyer to await the judge's decision. The judge ordered Richard Heaney to 90 days in jail, 4 years supervised probation, restitution, and 400 hours of community service. Of his 90 days in jail, Heaney can serve 60 days through work release, meaning he will only be in jail on weekends. Heaney's wife, Mayumi, was sentenced to 20 days in jail to be served after Richard's sentence is complete. Still ahead on Good Day Live, a review of the sci-fi flick Avatar in your weekly segment of Director's Cut. But first, here's Tom's trivia question. We'll have the answer at the end of the show. Stay with us. We'll be right back.